ceremony today, but for all your prayers, your shoulders, and all the things you've done to help us get through the last 16 months. Certainly has not been easy, but because you have been there for us, you have allowed us to be able to reconcile our situation, the loss of our parents, and move forward. And certainly to our elected officials, our illustrious city council member who had the foresight and thought it not robbery to move forward with a resolution that would co-name this corner after our parents. I want to thank you, and certainly all the other elected officials who have been involved in making this day possible. As I stand here, I'm reminded of the book of Joshua and what the Israelites did when they crossed the Jordan River after God had miraculously held back the waters. They planted 12 stones in order that future generations would ask, what do those stones represent? They were able to say those stones represent and will allow us to memorialize the miracle that God performed for us. So these signs, or this sign as it's pulled back, represents our 12 stones in the memory of Reverend Dr. Clarence Norman and Ellen Norman. And that future generations would probably probably say, they would ask, who was Reverend Norman? And we'd be able to say he was a man who walks amongst us, served his God, and loved his community, and gave his all. And he had the ability to do that because he had a loving wife by the name of Ellen Norman. So as we move forward, we need to think and remember that his memory, represented by his ministry, was one that was not just done inside the four walls of 450 Eastern Parkway, but it's done on the highways and byways of this borough and this community. So I think it's so befitting that the ceremony is not taking place inside the church, but it's happening outside the church, and that we are here to do this in his memory. We know that his ministry was not one just about preaching the gospel and healing broken souls, but it was also about healing broken bodies and broken communities. We know what he did with housing for seniors, housing for low-income families, providing programs for the youth, etc., etc., etc. And his memory will now live on forever. So for those of us who are gathered here today, let these signs, this street code naming, be a constant memory of not only his ministry, but the service that he gave and what we should do in terms of emulating the life that he lived of serving others. So precious memories will linger on, and we'll always remember Reverend Dr. Clarence Norman and his loving wife, Ellen Norman, and we thank you so much for this occasion. May God bless you all. Thank you. Yeah.